taken care of. Tim's just volunteered to take care of it. Take care of the project for us. Okay, I'll volunteer. I did ask if you wouldn't mind taking care of the projector, right? So, how are you doing on this stinky morning? I see you all aren't going to attend the 10:30 and see me stand out in the stickiness. Oh, wait a second. No, you're all here for the 9 o'clock, so you can come on then attend the 10:30, right? Yeah, I'll wait for you, right?
Don't wait.
Well, I am going to be out there at 10:30. We'll see how that goes. I haven't done that. Somebody asked me, the person, okay, Randy, who built the stage again, said, so how did it go last year? I said, Randy, really? How long have I been here, Randy? I don't know how it went last year, Randy. Because I've only been here since October. If you are visiting with us today, welcome. We welcome you to the First Lutheran Church here in South Sioux City. Today is Communion Day, yes it is. I was just double checking. Do I have any small children? Well, you're not small children. But do I have any children who would like to volunteer, if you'd like to volunteer to hold the baskets? Well, sit down. Okay. But if two children would like to volunteer to hold the baskets, and we need be, we'll have you guys do it as well. But I want to get some of the smaller children involved. For communion time, that would be great. Just have you hold the baskets so everybody can drop their leftover communion cups inside the basket. You look all worried over there. Don't worry, it's not our job. It's like this. That's it. If you didn't notice in the announcements, we have a picnic coming up. Anybody see that? We have a picnic coming up? Nobody saw that we have a picnic coming up? Okay, put your hand up if you saw we have a picnic. Thank you. We have a picnic coming up July 9th. We'll be following the second service. We have somebody that's going to be smoking a whole bunch of ribs that day. So they will be out early in the morning smoking ribs. So it will be terrible as you walk in. You don't have to smell those ribs as you come in. But we're going to have a picnic following that after the second service. And we're asking you to bring sides to go along with the ribs. And who was it? Rita and Mary Wolf. Are you here? Rita, I saw you around earlier. Okay. Mary? Okay, they're coming to the second service. Their houses got chosen by the chamberettes as yards of the month. So a round of applause for them. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Most merciful God, we confess that we are bondage to sin. Christ gives the power to become the children of God and bestows upon them the Holy Spirit. Please be seated. The children would like to come forward.
Thank you.
God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Holy is the Lord, the Almighty.
He was, he is, and he is to come.
He is worthy of glory and honor and power.
He created all things by his will and came to be.
Worthy is Christ, the Lamb who was slain.
Worthy to take his soul and break his seals.
By his blood he purchased for God. Christ made them a kingdom,
and increased to serve our God.
And they shall reign on earth forever.
Amen. Amen, Lord Jesus.
Let us pray. Almighty Creator and ever-living God, we worship your glory, eternal, three in one. And we praise your power, majestic, one and three. Keep us steadfast in this faith. Defend us into all adversity, and bring us at last into your presence, where you live in endless joy and love, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Please share the peace with one another now.
Sometimes I feel
That's the only time I hear of for sure that we know that God was walking on earth. But we don't have a picture of what he is. But we know that he is the creator of all things. The creator of everything. Creates out of nothing. So God is a creator. But also so is the Son. Now the Son is Jesus. Now the new creation is for us in that Son. Now Jesus, or the Son, was there at the time of creation. If you read back in John, you hear, in the beginning was the Word. And as you note, it's capitalized, so that's talking about the Son. So the Son was there in creation at the very beginning. And now again in the new creation, when he rises from the dead, which is for our benefit here and now. Not later on. It's for our benefit here and now. The kingdom of heaven has already come through and is starting to break through to be with each and every one of us. And Jesus promises to be there and gives us all the words necessary, all the words necessary that we need to go out and be with people and spread the word, the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. He gives us what we need. He promised that to us. And hopefully we're using those invite cards and inviting people to hear the word here. I hope. I pray. Because if we are not, then maybe we're not trusting in the promises of Jesus. He says to be there. But he also does it through the Holy Spirit, who resides where? Where? In us. We are the temple of God, and the Holy Spirit resides within us and around us to carry us through, to inspire us, to help us through Jesus Christ. Now, you ain't spinning yet? You got the whole Trinity doctrine down? It was all right there. You get it? No. It's okay. It's okay, as we talked about in the catechism class, it's okay to say, I don't know. But trust that the Holy Spirit, who imparts the faith on us, will bring us there. Will bring us there. So even when we don't understand why things happen the way that they do, and we may be walking through a bunch of muck at the time, and go, why am I having to go through this muck? That we trust that the Holy Spirit will get us through that muck. Will change things with us and the people around us. And it will be better. It will be better. Because no matter what, even if it's not better right here, right now, or in the next 30 seconds, or an hour from now, or 3 years from now, or 30 years from now, we do know that it will get better. When? Upon our death and resurrection. We know. That's why, as I said class this morning, I personally had a problem with the Lord's Prayer, where it says, save me from the time of trial. Because in my head, I hear, well, don't bring that kind of trial. But I want that time of trial, because it means the end is coming, which means heaven and earth are created new, which means everlasting life, which means, oh my goodness, bring it on. If it's tomorrow, let's go. Now, don't hear that I'm looking to die for, okay? No, I'm not suicidal. But I'm trusting in the promises. And if the time of trial comes tomorrow, I trust that the Holy Spirit is there with me, that Jesus Christ comes again, and God the Father loves us so much that he's making all of this happen. You heard me say over and over, it's all about the love. It's about the love of God for each and every one of us in Jesus Christ. It's about the promises of God for us. This is not for God. God doesn't create a new heaven and earth for him or God. If we're going to use the non-gender, as we talked about today as well. It's not for God's sake. It's always about for our sake. Everything that happens is about for our sake. That's how we understand it as being Lutheran. Everything that happens is done by God for us first. We didn't have to do anything special for that new life and the resurrection, did we? No. And isn't that a terrible two-way story? Not have to do anything? We could just sit in the pews and never respond in any way whatsoever. I mean, there's no requirement to Jesus died for us. Right? This is, well, because we were good, we invited somebody, Jesus died for us. Because if you listen to Luther, you listen to a lot of other people, and you listen to Paul. Paul tells you, I know what I'm supposed to do, yet I don't do it. That never happens for any of us, right? Yeah. It talks all the time. We try, but if it were up to us, we mess it up. We would mess it up, but God was perfect. Promised to be there with us through Jesus Christ in the Holy Spirit. So that even when we mess it up and we walk for our own money, we can pull us out of it. That life preserver and the Holy Spirit taking us back. Who remembers that first video that I showed you? The one with the play going on and the woman that was up there, everything was great, Danny, and then all of a sudden she started walking with the devil, started drinking, started gambling. Next thing you know, she had a gun to her head because everything was terrible. Who comes to her? Jesus. Throwing that life preserver, the Holy Spirit, pulling her back. Just pulling her back. Again, was she doing anything worthy of being saved? Do we? Do our merits save us? We are a flawed people, plain and simple. We are a sinful people. Plain and simple. We deserve none of the love that God gives us, yet we get it all because of Jesus Christ. We are blameless and sinners. I guess we're starting our own triuneness when we talk about that, because we are both saint and sinners. Biuneness. We are both saint and sinner. In the eyes of the triune God, fortunately, God chooses to look at us through the lenses of Jesus Christ and only see the blameless human being, the blameless child that He created, that God created. Yet, we go on through again. And through the power of the Holy Spirit and the promises of Jesus Christ, we are made new each and every day. So when we go out and see people and we tell them about who we are and what we want them to know, we go out and tell them in confidence, because we know that Jesus Christ will be there with us, in confidence that God is there for them. They have a new life. They need to come and experience it. And they have to do nothing. There's no entrance fee. There's no payment. Just come to me. So hopefully when we see somebody walking through the door, we run up to them, scare them, and give them a big hug, and say, welcome. Well, we may not want to scare them, right? Might not want to scare them. But we want to welcome them, because they are just like us in all their flaws. They're all welcome. And the words that we say will come from Jesus. When we invite somebody, the words that we say come from Jesus, because we hear today, I will be with you, where? To the end of age. No qualifications. He will be there with us. Let's share the gospel. Let's share the good news. Let's share this building. Let's share everything that we have. Let's share who we are. And most importantly, let's share who God is, our triune God. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
He came down from heaven.
the Spirit's embrace. Let us pray for the mending of God's world. Holy Mystery, you call us to be your church. Keep calling your people to faithful reform. Give us vision and courage to share your new life with all of the world. Lord, in your mercy. Joyful Creator, you made a wondrous universe and call us to be partners in its care. Inspire the light and the fury, the scaly, the watery, the breezy, the sandy, the stuff you love. Inspire us to bring about creation's healing. Lord, in your mercy. Merciful God, you love your enemies and bless all people. Make our hearts yearn to be joyful and share your generosity. Help leaders and citizens use political power in service of your, in your peace. Lord, in your mercy. Compassionate, loving Father, we come to you with many people on our hearts, many concerns, people that we know, things happening in the world. We ask that you send your Holy Spirit to continue to be with them and guide them, comfort them, and give them all that they need. Today, we lift up to you all the people on our prayer list that, Lord, I ask you again, forgive me, I forgot to bring up here. But you know who's on there. You know who's there. You know the joys and the thanksgivings. You know the people that need your comfort. But we also lift up to you those that we say now out loud or silently within our hearts. Lord, in mercy. Holy Trinity, you call us together to bless your world. Guide all who are preparing for baptism into the joy of new life in your name. Lord, in your mercy. All these things and whatever else you see that we need, we entrust to your care through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. You may be seated and we'll take up today's offerings. go out and invite people. Spread the news of our God, our triune God. Please rise if you're able.
Thank you.
Almighty God, you gave your Son both as a sacrifice for sin and a model of godly life. Enable us to receive him always with thanksgiving and to conform our lives to his, through the same Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and give you grace. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. We'll continue with our closing hymn, number 535. Stay cool. Hope to see you back at 10:30 in your cars.